I get to. I just wanted to get on here again and let you know everything is okay.
Hey everybody, it's Mary. Welcome to my channel. If you are a new subscriber here, or if you're not, please hit the subscribe button. I'd love to have you here. If you are a subscriber of mine, this will be a different kind of video. This video is a tribute video to my very, very good friend here, Spunky. I'm going to try not to call her that in this video because the rest of you get confused when I call her that. In any case, she called me either Sexy Mary or Sexy Mama, and I called her Spunky. She was my Spunky friend. And if you knew her, then you know you don't have to question why I called her Spunky. She's sassy, she's spunky, she was full of vinegar. There was really nobody like her. Okay, but how I came to know her was really rather funny. Cece was watching my videos. She was a subscriber to my channel. And she was watching my videos, and she was watching, not just my videos, okay, but at the time I thought it was just me, right? She was watching these YouTube videos from her Google Plus, because if you remember, you used to have a Google Plus account in order to be able to make comments on YouTube. So what she was doing was, she was watching people's videos on Google Plus, and therefore, since there wasn't really a way, she was tagging onto other people's comments. So what happened was, she was like following me from, not just on my videos, but other people's. I would make comments on other people's videos, and then Cece would tag on to my comment on their videos. And I didn't understand what was going on. I thought I had a stalker. I think she's stalking me or something. And I'm like, well, I wonder why. Okay, but, you know, I would just be nice and whatnot. But, okay, so anyway, it was shortly after that my friend Susie Clancy did a video shout out for CC Charles. Well, I thought, well, I know her. She's that girl who's always tagging along with me and making comments to people on my comments. And it was at that point I was like, wow, I didn't know she made videos. So I went to her channel, and that's when I fell in love with CC. CC is, her channel started, I mean, she wasn't just ours. And when I say ours, I'm talking to the mature beauty community. Cece has been here for 4 years on YouTube making videos. But she had a channel, and she changed the name of it recently, not too long ago. She changed it from, I think it was Stroke Survivor. It was long, the name of it. And she changed it to Cece Charles and More. And that is because she wasn't just the stroke survivor anymore. So back in 2008, she suffered this stroke. And so her channel was initially to raise awareness for people so that they understood the signs of stroke and what to look for. And also to help people with tips and tricks about how to deal with it.
And remember your system. Fast. Face weakness. Arm weakness. And speech. If you don't understand anyone, they could be hurting. And they don't know it yet.
She was the single most positive person that I've ever met in my life and stuff. I had a very special relationship with her in that she kept me going. You know, she was the strongest person that I knew. I never knew her to let things upset her, stop her. She had high goals and she was making them. I watched her go from somebody who had to crawl like a baby on the floor. I didn't actually see her do that, but I heard her talk about it when she lived with her parents, to how proud she was when she got her apartment. I believe it was in the fall of 2015 when she got her own apartment. And she was so proud of that apartment. She wanted to do it more than anything. She wanted to do it on her own. She had goals and she was meeting them. She was happy. She was a Christian. She loved the Lord. She was thankful for her life. Even being limited the way she was thankful for her life and everything in it. So many little things to say about Cece. She was a diabetic on top of the other things that were going on. She was also a diabetic. So if you ever feel sorry for yourself, hop your butt over to Cece's channel and take a listen to her. She was an example that we should all follow. We are her people.
She is my biggest inspiration. Cece had a stroke several years ago, and she inspires me every single time I watch a video. She is happy. She is appreciative. She uplifts me. She uplifts me. I love her.
It's Natalie the Beauty Diva, and I'm here on behalf of myself and also of Susie Clancy. And this is just to talk about Cece Charles, and what she meant to us. Cece was an inspiration to all of us. Her strength, her smile, her willingness to keep on going. She raised the bar. She truly raised the bar. And when I heard of her passing last week, I was crushed. I was just so crushed. Such a beautiful, beautiful soul who had so much courage and integrity and dignity. And I want us all to remember her as this wonderful woman who brought us so much joy into our lives. We're gonna miss you. We miss you, Cece. You hold a very special place in my heart. And for anyone who is ever have any doubts about starting a channel, you just need to go watch Cece, and then you will realize that if she can do it, we were her friends, and we loved her. And she came on, and you know what? She supported us, and we love her. We loved her. We will miss her. God bless you, Cece, and my sincere condolences to the Charles family.
My deepest condolences to Cece's family. And Cece, if you're watching this, know that you were loved, and you were an inspiration to a lot of the women here, and I'm sure in your real life, too. You will be missed, and we love you very much.
My first time of meeting Cece, she actually came to my channel and commented. And as I do, I always comment back to everybody. And a lot of times I'll go back and check and see if they have a channel or make videos. And lo and behold, she did. And I went to go check one of her videos out. I have to say, pretty much she captured my heart right away. Because knowing of her being a stroke survivor and sitting there and just with this big smile on her face, talking about makeup, she just seemed so happy and so bubbly. And I thought, wow, I really love to be like her, have this very good positive outlook. Some of the happy memories I have of her is I always laughed at her giggle that she would do, and she would show things that, she loved her owls. She had collected lots of owls, and she would take and grasp with her hand this ball, and she was determined to get all that strength back into her hand and arm. Simple things. She would get out of her wheelchair and get into bed, like show us how she did that. Very, very proud. Simple things in life that we take for granted, she was always proud of. Impression for me with her that she had always given me days like where I was really maybe struggling, like in my own life, that to think positive, that you can do it. I'm grateful for just even that bit that I had with her. Deuces.
Cece was always such a kind, beautiful person. She's always smiling all the time and so happy. And it just seemed like didn't matter what came her way, she was always had a smile on her face. And every time she would post on my videos, she'd be like, "Oh, that's so pretty, you know, I like the glitter," or "I wish I could wear glitter," or something like that, because she knows that I like the shiny stuff. So she was always, she was a hoot, you know, she's a good friend. She's, you know, she was always so kind to everyone and so loving. And I loved her deuces at the end all the time. So I'm really going to miss her. And, you know, she'll always have a piece of our hearts, you know, the people here on YouTube that she has touched, and, we miss her very much. Love you, Cece. Deuces.
Hi, everybody. Today I wanted to share my memories of Cece Charles. And I don't remember how we met, if she watched my channel or I watched her channel, but I immediately fell in love with her, and she was such an inspiration to me. I have a son who has cerebral palsy, and when she would show little bits of her therapy or what her mom would do for her, I would always ask her questions, and she was so encouraging, and she would always say, "Please ask more questions, whatever you want to know." And I just loved her spirit, and she was so inspiring. And I'm so grateful that we have her videos to look back on and watch. And of course, we always will remember her saying deuces and her wonderful smile and the way she loved to show off her new makeup. And I just want to thank you, Cece, for all your wonderful videos. Okay, Cece, we love you. Bye.
I have been trying to remember who led me to Cece's channel. I think it was Mary, Miss Glitzy Fritzy. I think it was Mary. Not sure, but I'm almost guaranteeing you that's who it was. But you know what? It didn't matter, because once you went there and you got captured by her smile and her excitement, I think that's one thing that just captured everybody and made Cece part of our family, was just that smile and that positive energy. She loved everything. She was passionate about it, about life, her excitement about her YouTube family, makeup, it all. She loved it, and it showed through. It was so contagious. Her love, her life, her smile, just all of it. She became quickly my hero. I think one of the fondest memories of Cece once was when I had made some comments, and she knew that I was having some issues with my sister's health and spending a lot of time with my sister. And she said to me, "You're amazing, and I am honored that you watch my videos." And I said, "Cece, honey, I'm nothing special. You are my hero. You are amazing." And she said, "No, no. Your sister's lucky to have you, and I'm lucky you're my friend. But Cece, the honor, all mine. You're my hero. You have made my eyes open to so many things, and I love you, and I will see you again one day, sweet lady. Till then, deuces."
Cece belonged to many communities, not just the mature beauty community. Every community opened their arms and let her in because how could you not love Cece? Her smile alone was enough to make you fall in love with her, but I can hear her in my head laugh. I love to hear Cece laugh.
I can hold up. I got a grip like this, like nothing. Sometimes I can talk to my hair, say, let go, but the grip of this, oh my goodness, it won't let go.
She would want us to celebrate that she's out of that chair, that she is dancing, because Cece loved to dance, okay? You might not know that. Let's talk about the things that Cece loved. Cece loved Skippy peanut butter. She loved fish and rice, her mama's fish and rice. She had just turned 44 years old, I believe on August 10th. She loved BH Cosmetics and Elf. she actually got me to try a few things because I did it. She loved chocolate. She loved Hello Kitty. She loved pink. She loved, the singer and the color. She was fearless. She was faithful. She was enthusiastic. She loved owls. You see that owl? It's not lit up right now, but I bought that for me because it represented Cece, and it mostly sits right there on top of that little thing right there, but today I've pulled it up here. You can see that owl sometimes in my videos, and it represents her. She loved all kinds. She loved rap music. She loved, but you didn't know that. Yeah, she did. She liked Tupac, Will.i.am, Green Day, they're not rap, but she liked them. She liked, she had good taste in men, okay? She knew a good looking man when she saw him, right? She was gaga over that guy, Robert Pattinson, is that his name? Twilight guy, you know, he was in Twilight. She loved Twilight. She loved the series Twilight. She loved gaming. She had started a Twitch account. I remember I would try to help her out as much as I could, and I remember my internet was out at this particular time. She was trying to learn Google Hangouts, and oh my gosh, I was brutal to watch her because she was struggling with it, couldn't get it to work and stuff, and I couldn't help her because I didn't have an internet connection. But I let her know about YouNow. So she went over to YouNow and she made a bunch of friends there. Cece made friends wherever she went. She wasn't just ours. Cece was everything I'm not but want to be. She was my hero. She was my incentive. She was the thought in my head whenever I said I can't. Whenever I drug my butt out of this house to go for a walk and I didn't want to do it and I hurt, my back would hurt, and I would feel so sorry for myself, and I'd say, you can walk. And speaking of walking, she went from crawling to, she was standing, okay? She was standing and she was gonna drive, and we had a pact. She was gonna drive, and see, I suffer from these panic attacks, right? So she was going to drive a car, and we were going to go together. I suffered from panic attacks, and I was going to go to get her in my Mustang and let her drive it. We were going to go. We were going to do stuff to you guys because she's funky like that. She'll never be forgotten.
Best. You can be the King Kong banging on your chest.
You could beat the world, you could beat the war. You could talk the guy, go banging on his door.
You can throw your hands up, you can beat the
the clock. Yeah. You can move a mountain, you can break rocks.
You can be a master, don't wait for luck. Dedicate yourself and you go find yourself.
Standing in the Hall of Fame.
Yeah.
And the world's gonna know your name.
You can run the mile. You can walk straight through hell with a smile. You could be the hero, you could get the gold. Breaking all the records they thought never could be broke.
Yeah, do it for your people, do it for your pride. And you're never gonna know if you never even try.
Do it for your country, do it for your name.
Cause there's gonna be a day when you're
standing in the Hall of Fame.
Yeah.
And the world's gonna know your name.
Thank you so much. You are my people, guys. Thank you so much. You are my people. Anyway, I hope to see you guys soon.
Yeah. We are her people. Okay, so if you're not having a blessed day, please go out and be a blessing to somebody else. Until next time. Love you. See ya. Bye. I'm out.
Another turning point, a fork stuck in the road. Time grabs you by the wrist, directs you where to go. So make the best of this test and don't ask why. It's not a question but a lesson learned in time. It's something unpredictable, but in the end is right. I hope you had the time of your life. So take the photographs and still frames in your mind, hanging on a shelf in good health and good time. Tattoos and memories, dead skin on trial. For what it's worth, it was worth all the while. It's something unpredictable, but in the end is right. I hope you had the time of your life.